Hello, this is Jeff Tomlinson, your Northern Utah real estate expert. I hope I can say expert. I've been in the industry now for 17 years. If I'm not an expert now, I guess I never will be. But anyways, I just wanted to spend a couple minutes with you guys to talk about our local real estate and what's going on. The reason that I'm bringing this up now, and I usually don't talk much about our real estate market because it's been going up and up now for nearly 2 years. But guess what I found? You hear that sound? That's right. It's the air coming out of our real estate bubble. I think we finally reached the point where prices have maxed out and that we're going to start seeing a pullback. So I started doing some searching and I came across a couple of articles. The first one was published in ABC News. It reports on April 27th that three Utah cities, now among the most overpriced markets in the nation. Those three cities are Ogden, Salt Lake, and Provo. And, you know, it's never good, in my opinion, especially if you're on the buyer side, to pay for something that's overpriced. It doesn't make sense. But now there's proof that things are starting to pull back. But it's interesting that that article came out because on May 24th, Realtor.com posted this article. And both of these links are below that you can go review them and read them for yourself. But it says, the housing market is showing signs of a correction. What this means for buyers and sellers. And I've seen the signs for about 2 or 3 months now and showing to me and to my clients, hey, there is something that's going on. And so that's why I wanted to start digging into a little bit more deeply. And I found those articles, plus I'm seeing these local things. And I wanted to show you my evidence based upon these pullbacks. First off, reduced home prices. The homes that are coming on the market are coming a little bit lower than what they have been. And sellers, homes that have been on the market, we're seeing some price reductions by 20 to 50,000, sometimes more, sometimes less, but it's an average. And the number of homes coming on the market has been increasing. We have been in a severe shortage, but now we're having more homes in our inventory, which is good. Buyers have been struggling to find homes. The next thing is that sellers are willing to pay buyers' closing costs as well as home warranties. Before, that just wasn't happening, and in fact, the sellers wouldn't even consider your offer if you had anything in there like that. Homes are staying active on the market for weeks, not days like they used to be. So that's another pullback. Also, homeowners are not getting multiple offers like they used to. We're seeing sometimes just 2 or 3 and sometimes just 1. So that's another indication. The rise in interest rates has been a significant one in my opinion. Buyers can't afford to make the payments anymore. What traditionally we've seen a lot of buyers that we've been working with is that increases have come between $500 to $700 more a month. That's a lot. And they simply can't do it and won't do it. In fact, the lenders won't even provide them the loan for what they're looking for because it's too much debt to income ratio for them. Also, we're seeing an inflation, as you know, everything's costing more. And so that means that their income's going down and they can't afford the higher payments. So the buyer said, nope, I'm out. Sellers are making repairs asked by the buyers after their inspections, which generally over the last couple of years, we wouldn't even ask because for fear of them just saying, no, we're not going to do them, or they'll go with a backup offer. Also, home purchases are down for about 24% from what we've seen. And the last indicator that I noticed, which is something I found interesting, is that the title companies are reporting that they are actually laying people off. And we haven't seen that for a long time. So what does all this mean? Well, we're seeing changes and they're happening. And I want to give you that information because I think it's extremely important that the people I work with and or know find out for yourself what the facts are. And that's what I'm trying to give to you right now is what are the facts? What are we seeing? So the market is pulling back, which I think is good. It has been too high for too long, in my opinion. But now that you know, you guys use that information to leverage whatever position you might be in. And if you got any questions for me, please contact me. You can get a hold of me on my Facebook page or YouTube, email, text, phone call, whatever works. We're here to help to serve you because we know how important real estate transactions are to all of you. So once again, thanks for watching. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Love to have you stay up to date on the latest information, because there's a lot of other videos I've created for you in regards to real estate. So have a great day, and we'll see you later.